Yeah, Dina, Steve, this is one of the most fascinating and entertaining oral arguments I've seen here in state court. A former appellate court judge, Sheila O'Brien, has filed a petition asking the court to appoint a special prosecutor to investigate if Kim Fox properly handled the Jussie Smollett case. But before the court can even get to that issue, they first have to decide whether the presiding judge, Leroy Martin Sr., should be the judge to hear this case at all. As it turns out, his son is an assistant state's attorney in juvenile court. He has been for a year. Fox actually hired him and is his boss. O'Brien says that means Martin should not hear this case. She told the judge today he needs to recuse himself because the voters need to know he is fair and impartial. She said, "You will have to decide whether your son's boss is telling the truth. That puts you in a precarious position, so why do it? Just take the higher ground and recuse yourself." To that, Judge Martin said, wow. He did not like it that his family was being drawn into the mix. He says he hears cases all of the time that involve the state's attorney's office, and it has never been an issue before. But O'Brien says this case is different because Kim Fox herself could be called as a witness. She will be questioned about whether she's been telling the truth. And while there's been no decision today on any of these issues, they will be back in court next week. Judge Martin will decide if he should recuse himself or whether he should appoint an altogether different judge who is not from Cook County. Still to be determined is whether this is a case in the first place. Should a special prosecutor even be appointed? The state's attorney's office says absolutely not. There is no need here, but we are not there yet. This is going to be a very long legal road.
Big thing to point out, I think, is that Ms. Fox, as the elected state's attorney, she has wide and broad discretion as to whether to bring a case or not bring a case. As an example, had she wanted to dismiss the Van Dyke case, she could have done it and not be questioned about it because she has that ultimate authority. And then the question is, can somebody from the judiciary then go ahead and appoint somebody to look into whether or not she did the right thing?
Now, noticeably absent from court today, both Kim Fox and Jussie Smollett. Smollett's lawyers say it would have been an inconvenience for him to travel here from California. Kim Fox, again, doesn't feel like this is the proper, was a proper petition, that she doesn't feel like this is even a real case, and so she doesn't feel like she should have to show up to court either. Likely neither of those parties will be in court throughout this litigation unless the judge orders them to be there.